Hello, my dear students. I hope you are fine and listening to your parents. I am Flora ma'am and today I am going to teach you English Literature. Chapter 4, A Wonderful Gift. Dear students, please watch my explanation and do the exercise given below. Take care of yourself, be safe and listen to your parents. Thank you. Introduction. Every one of us have a special gift in us. We should make use of this special gift to fulfill our dreams. A long time ago, there lived in America a little boy named Benjamin West. So, a long time ago, there lived a little boy in America named Benjamin West. Benjamin loved pictures, but he had never seen any pictures except a few small ones in a book. He loved the bright and beautiful colors. His father and mother did not think it was right to spend money for such things. They thought the pictures might take his mind away from more useful things. So Benjamin loved colorful pictures, okay, but his parents did not like it. His parents used to think if he'll be more interested in coloring, then he won't be able to do other things. One day, Benjamin's mother had to go out for some work. She told Benjamin to stay in the house and take care of his baby sister until she came back. So one day, Benjamin's mother wanted to go out and there was no one to look after Benjamin's little sister. So Benjamin's mother told Benjamin to look after his baby sister. He was glad to do this because he loved the baby. She was asleep in her crib. For a while, he sat very still. He did not want to make any noise and wake her. He could hear the clock ticking. He heard the birds singing. Soon he began to feel a little lonely. So Benjamin was very happy that he had his sister with him and he loved his baby sister. So the baby was sleeping in a crib and he did not want to disturb the baby. So he heard the birds singing. Soon he began to feel a little lonely. So he was sitting and admiring his sister, but then after some time he started feeling lonely. A fly sat on the baby's cheek and he brushed it away. Then he thought what a pretty picture he could make of his sister's lovely face and her little hands. So while he was sitting and watching his sister, he saw a fly was sitting on his sister's cheek. So he chased the fly and he was admiring her beautiful face and her little hands. He had no paper, but he found a piece of cardboard. He had no pencil, but he found a piece of black charcoal. He began to draw. The baby smiled but did not wake up. So he saw his sister sleeping. So he wanted to draw her picture. He had no paper with him. He had only a piece of cardboard. And he had no pencil. But he got a piece of charcoal from the fire. So he started drawing on the cardboard. picture grew as the charcoal touched the cardboard. Here was her round head covered with pretty curls. Here was her mouth. Here were her little round eyes and her small ears. And here were her tiny hands. So while he was drawing, he started saying that, "See, this is my little baby sister's face, round face. This is her pretty curls, her two beautiful eyes, her small ears." He kept on saying and started drawing. He kept on admiring his sister. It was very quiet in the house. He was so busy drawing that he did not think of anything else. He did not even hear his mother's footsteps as she came into the room. So he was very busy drawing. And his mother entered the room, but he was so busy that he could not hear the footstep of his mother. "Oh, Benjamin, what have you been doing?" she cried. The boy sprang up alarmed. "It's only a picture of the baby, mother," he said. So when his mother entered, his mother asked him, "Benjamin, what are you doing?" And he got scared, he got frightened, and he jumped up. And then he said, "Mother, this is only a picture of my baby sister."